Drugs are everywhere, more than ever. Drugs can be anything. Anybody can have a problem with substance use. In 97, when the member states decided to create the early warning system, nobody would have guessed that 10 years later, we would have two new psychoactive substances discovered on the European market every week. Whatever happens in the world and around the EU potentially also has an impact or consequences on the territory of the EU. Today, you have threats for health, certainly. You have threats for security related to drug trafficking and drug production on the EU territory. We have also threats for the environment, but it is also more broadly a threat to the rule of law and to the society.
What we're trying to do is really provide the evidence to inform policies and actions. So we're really trying to provide an accurate description of who uses different psychoactive substances and the consequences of that use, and also what sorts of interventions might be affected in dealing with that. What we provide by having a scientific perspective is a cold assessment of the evidence, both of what the problem is, but also what are the effective solutions. So on one hand, we're doing, I think, basic social science. We're also looking at survey research. We're looking at understanding of the meanings of people involved in this area. And at the other end of the scale, we're now increasingly using quite sophisticated new forensic and toxicological measures to understand better some of the new substances that are appearing in the drugs area.
We are at the eve, potentially, of another perfect storm, a new syndemic because of the availability of drugs, because of COVID consequences in terms of mental health, because of the economic recession, because of the huge problem we face already with drug-related violence and corruption, with the threats to environment, and the fact that those vulnerable groups that are suffering more from lockdown, from problems of mental health, and from the economic recession, some of them could be driven to drug-related criminal activities. There is an interest for the countries to jointly cooperate with the EU to benefit from the advanced evidence-based knowledge experience in what are the well-established responses or methods for prevention, for treatment and harm reduction, for instance. Our ultimate goal is to help people who use drugs and their families. We are not there just to produce stats. It's completely useless if you do it only to write books that will remain in the bookshelf. But we need additional resources to fulfill better our role. We should have more interaction, more co-production, and what we do already more than 5 years ago or 10 years ago is to associate partners, including association of professionals working on the drug field, association of people who are using drugs. We need to make sure we don't miss a very important threat that is emerging and that may have a very negative impact for our population.